question in regards to temporaries. Building workforce is increasing. Health and teaching development.
Hi, everyone. My name is Ayush. I'm a student at Washington University in St. Louis. And today I'll talk to you guys about a program that started in high school, which was focused on delivering STEM outreach into low-income neighborhoods. And since then, we have decided that we could probably do a health education resource in parallel with that in St. Louis. So I'll first go over the high school, the things I did in high school, and then go into what I've been doing currently. So before I go into the details of the project itself, I'll talk a little bit about motivation for this project. So it came from my own personal experience. I went to an inner city middle school and elementary school in which there's not a lot of funding to do a lot of science experiments. A lot of the day is mundane, kind of textbook reading and assignments, but not really hands-on learning and being able to interact with what you learn in the classroom. And that's something I knew was important, especially in high school, to get me interested in studying engineering later at my university. Another thing is that there are not a lot of minorities in STEM in the United States. A very small percentage of women are in STEM, and a majority of STEM workforce is dominated by white people. So one thing that really caught my eye is that in order for STEM to succeed, to solve the problems of tomorrow, we really need to diversify the number of people and the types of people who are in the STEM fields, and I thought this would be a great opportunity to go to elementary school students and really encourage them and get them excited about science. And then a picture right here kind of shows the health disparities of how education plays an important aspect in the health environment in the United States. And some students aren't able to attend university and go to college. So our goal is hopefully, by at least getting them aware of healthy habits at an early age, we can hopefully narrow this gap in the future. So the program started at Science for Shooting Stars. It's a mnemonic for science, technology, and applied research. We started our program in 4 locations within the state of Massachusetts, and it was completely run by high school student volunteers across the state. We mainly wanted to target students on ages 7 to 14, because we thought that was the main cohort that really needed to get that experience of different types of science. We got most of our funding through local universities and high schools, which were willing to give us different materials as well as money to spend on different equipment that we could use throughout our development. So when we first started the program, we got a lot of the lessons plans and presentations by collaborating with each other and teachers across the state on what we should make sure that the students go away from or learn and how to apply what they learn in the classroom. So the basic stuff we did was biology, chemistry, and physics. We did a lot of activities to get them excited about it. The main ones were everyone liked the ice cream using dry ice, kind of get them interested in phases and how those work, as well as showing them chemical reactions with Mentos and soda. So there's a picture right there of we did it in the gymnasium. And then we want to really maintain their interest and curiosity for it. So we always gave them supplies and resources to take home that they can play with. One thing we did a lot was give them access to different things they were interested in. One student was really interested in spectrometers, and we were luckily able to get that from a local university, and they used that very extensively. And we also provided a really strong mentor-mentee relationship among students, so that even today, we have contact with these elementary school students and really encourage them to pursue and give them the resources they need in order to pursue a STEM field. So this is just an example of what we do. We usually give like a 5 to 10 minute presentation on, for example, cell biology. Usually if we do it longer than that, we lose their interest real quick. So our goal is just to give them a basic background about it. And then on that day, we did 2 things. We did DNA extractions and taught them the entire process of doing it, and they were really excited about that whole experience, and then how to use a microscope and be able to use see different types of cells, which was really exciting as well. And we have different lessons similar to this, and we do this about once a week across different locations in the state of Massachusetts. And we were able to develop a state science fair in our third year, the first ever elementary school science fair in the state of Massachusetts. So we kind of developed this pyramid, we call, of how to come up with an idea, a project, and really get involved with it. And we always give them resources they need in order to pursue these projects. So we were able to gather about 100 students across the state, and we came together in Boston, Massachusetts for this science fair. We had different elementary school student teachers and researchers come and look at their projects. So the picture right here is of Kyle. He won the entire thing, and he did a pretty cool project on understanding circuits and the main components and how they affect the entire system. And today he even says he loves electricity and magnetism and really wants to pursue a field with that in the future. So it's been really exciting to see how the students have kind of evolved and really grown to appreciate different fields of science and really enjoy it as well. So now we're trying to develop some health education opportunities through this program. A lot of these students come from neighborhoods where there's not a lot of healthy habits that's instilled into them, and we want to make sure that they at least get an idea of what some of proper healthy habits can occur. Also, as we've been talking to some parents about different healthcare plans that are constantly changing in the United States, at least give them some sort of resource that they can contact whenever they feel they don't understand what's happening. So currently, this program has been transferred into St. Louis, where I am studying right now. And we've currently gathered about 15 college students, and we've been working with the Boys and Girls Club, which is an after-school program in the United States. And we go there about once every other week. And we've got a lot of funding, and we've been doing a similar program. We've just started the health education part, so we're excited to see where this venture takes us and whether it will be success in the future. Thank you.
Question.
Yeah, absolutely. So a lot of my high school friends and students across at different universities there have been considering expanding this program. Yeah, but as of right now, it's a lot of resource and time that we haven't found the people to really get involved with. But definitely we put it out there that we want people at different universities to really adopt this program, and we'll definitely help them if they want to.
Yes, but if you extend this program, do you think you continue to see the response by the University of Massachusetts?
Probably not at the University of Massachusetts. Hopefully we can connect with other universities in the local area. So that's the plan once we get to that point.
Yes, very good. Please, question for me.
By the state.